Time to die, Concelhaut. Welcome back. This is the RPG chick. Sneak mode.
Let's see what we got.
Sure.
Oh, you're all the way back there. Just wait for you to catch up.
How may I help?
Can help by going over here. I'm gonna try to spread them apart a little bit. I mean, their spells still need a reach and stuff. They're in there. We can't see them now. Concelhaut's here. They got two ghouls over here. I think the wand's over here somewhere. Concelhaut, two ghouls, and a wand. We should be able to take them. Last episode was almost an hour long. Optional episode, so I'll just briefly describe. We kept pulling them out around here, pulling them out one or two at a time. Destroyed all the little the sphere things, whatever the hell they're called. Pulled out death guards and ancient death guards, and the ghouls we couldn't grab. They ran back too quickly. So the stragglers were the others, the slow ones.
Hey.
Unfortunately, these guys gonna have to stick together in the doorway so that we don't let these guys through as much as we can. Anyway, where is she?
Hey.
Guess I'll have him grab it. He has the most points and such like that.
I'm ready.
Okay.
What?
Try to have these guys hang a little behind. I know when they cast some spells, they're going to run up more, though. So that's the thing.
Hey.
All right, what do we have?
Hey.
I have to remember to switch him back. He's just gonna pull. He's gonna shoot something and run back.
Alright then.
Healing, and so we can draw the enemy back. He said I have to move up a little to
hit
that.
Aethys!
For Aethys! Is that what he said?
Hey.
Switch him back. Oh, you know what I wanted? I wanted to eat some foodstuffs. Can we do that really quick? Did I get rid of that stuff? Oh, I think Canna has it. No one has it in quick slots, pretty sure. Okay, you know what we're gonna do? Can't be changing combat anyway, so never mind. Take a potion. Regen. How long does this last for? Over 20 seconds? She doesn't have that. I know I should just probably turn her invisible, but she's gonna get hit by a blast anyway. Everyone take your potion. I don't know. Hopefully that stacks. Good thing is we do barely reach everyone too. Actually, you know what? Here. Mirror image.
Hey.
Take your potions.
Breathe.
Breathe.
Breathe. Breathe. Breathe. Breathe. Breathe. Breathe.
Did they take him? Wait. Four. He didn't take his. I guess he got interrupted taking it. Yeah, Algol interrupted Adair. Okay. There's that wand. I want to take out that wand. It might not get close enough, though. We might have to just withstand it. Knock back. Let's wait for other people to take position, I guess. Very minor heal for now, because we're not really damaged. I know we're going to use the big one shortly. I'm trying to be smart here. Here comes that wand. Let's see if we can get that thing. Now, I'd love to just keep him in the doorway. I'm not sure if that's going to work. So he's still got it. He's still got Aeloth. But we can't reach the killing bolt from here. Wait. Can hit that. So he shouldn't run forward for that. I don't know if we can knock down a freaking wand, but we can try. You're gonna have to move slightly in. So I do want to start interrupting his spells. They're pretty messed up. Once I take out the wand, I'll have the heavy hitters concentrate on Concelhaut. Look at that, he's got four already? Oh, he's got three, nice. I guess from previous times we damaged him, I'm not sure. That's not our highest healing, it's our second highest. I'll try to keep up on the damage here. Let's see if we can do a run around him and get counsel on. We got a Spectre. Send the Spectre to get him. I think we can do this, guys. Did we get rid of the... Aeloth killed the animated wand already. Cool. Just two Algols left in this guy. It's in the bag. So she's invisible now. Let's see if we can run through and blind that guy. You know what? I think we have to actually, in order to sneak attack, we can't hit this and attack. We have to move her over right next to him and then attack, because she's visible now. Try another clear out. I'm not even using us to our greatest ability here, because these guys aren't doing anything. Killing bolt. Another low grade heal. Theodas. So she can run around and attack him. Oh, getting hurt. Powerful heal. Oh man, Aeloth all the way back here getting hit? Take a potion. That's the Algol. It's laying down, so you know what? Hit him. She could continue to hit this. Try another knockdown. Doesn't seem like we can knock him down, but we can try. Gotta keep up on those heals. Did you take your potion? You need to take that potion. Can I move him or her away from that? Or is she stuck? Crushing doom. Prone. Alright, so it's gonna hit her over and over. That's gonna be fun. Withering strike on him. These algals are just tough. Really had trouble getting him under two, so I don't know if maybe he heals himself at that point. Lower grade heal here. Okay, Aeloth. Killing Bolt. Oh boy. Sap. Ah, this algal is down to one. Marked enemy. That's a dare. Into the fray, which I don't know, I can't tell if that does. I think it does a little bit of additional damage. I'll try to watch the log here, see what happens. Well, this is just for a dare, really. A dare hits Algol. Okay. Is Concelhaut prone? I don't know. Maybe he's in the middle of casting a spell. This thing is almost dead. Who's this? Aeloth? Still casting that? Eventually she'll get up, but until then, we gotta heal her. Oh, thank God. Down to one. And we killed that Algol. Okay. Sworn enemy. Sap, once again. Hit him. Endurance. What about interdiction? Why not? Aeloth. Killing bolt.
Eh? Stuns an exhaust in that, you bastard!
Minor heal. Or more of a minor heal, anyway. Still casting them. Did we get him? I think maybe we got him. Aloth killed Concelhaut. Nice, Aloth. We did it, guys. I'll just beat up this thing. Well done. Nice. I'm very proud of myself. I've defeated Concelhaut, one of the greatest wizards in Eora. Too bad he was such a douche. His fault. Being a jerk to me, man. Trying to steal my soul. You have a responsibility, damn it. Legendary adventure, come on. Sagani. Fine wand, the iron clasp, grimoire. Nice. A broad belt of power, braces of deflection. We have that. Boots of stability, spell word amulet. Nice, cool things in here. Turquoise. What is this? His helmet? His skull. We can have it as a pet. The skull floats through some mysterious power of its own, chattering its teeth and rolling its burning eyes. You detect Concelhaut's energy and essence still pound inside it. That's awesome. Grants visage of Concelhaut. Nice. 40 Aurora damage over 20 seconds. You know, this is one pet we're gonna have. This is one pet we will keep. Spirit residue and binding copper. Let's see what this other stuff is. A broad belt of power. +2 might and +2 resolve. Aptly named, this belt is comprised of a broad span of boiled leather, joined in front by a silver buckle. Arcane spells have been forged into the material, and it grants those who wear it undeniable strength and a newfound sense of determination, which, even if it is induced, can rouse even the meekest of individuals to action. Induced. Alright, someone might want this belt. Boots of stability. +30 defense against prone attacks, +15 defense against push attacks. Standard boots description. Spell word amulet. +10 defense against spells. We have some really good amulets, so I'm not sure we'll use that. And another one? Okay. We got two? Or just one? We got the other one. Oh, yeah. We have two spell word amulets. Pretty cool. Because this, yeah, we'd have to give up Cloak of Protection. Ranged attacks, I'm not sure. This might include spells, so I'll keep that. Healing bonus. I don't want to take away the healing bonus. Yeah, we got some good stuff. I don't know. +10 isn't that great, is it? Maybe we'll keep one just in case. We need it to defeat somebody. To give us that little edge, you know? Alright, so he has all this stuff. Boots of stability. Oh, this only grants +1 constitution. Still hear that whispering. It's enough to drive you mad. Those are really good belt. Good boots. I'm actually going to give them to Theodas. I'm really fond of the Fulvano's line of clothing, for lack of a better term, but... Wait. There you go. Now, only one person can have a pet, right? Okay. So we're gonna have this skull be our little pet. That's awesome. To remind us that we killed this guy. Hooray. He never took this regeneration. Oh well. Alright, what else? Belt of Power. +2 Might and Resolve. Well, that's a ring. Belts aren't very common. +1 Endurance. I guess forever. It's for watchful presence. I don't know if that's automatic. +3 might also. +3 con. This is pretty sweet. Well, that's a ring. Never mind. Helps with crit damage. Who's this? Oh. And that's pretty good too. This I use to knock down pretty often. I really enjoy that. This is what I was looking for. This dragon meat dish, but we couldn't drag it, you know. It gives you pretty much, I mean, I'm figuring that's the entire battle. But we can't switch it out during combat. It was too late, so... +2 might, +2 resolve. What do you think? What's better? What do you guys think? -27% crit damage? Or +2 might and resolve? Channeling magic. Might. It contributes to both damage and healing, as well as the fortitude defense. Helps maintain concentration, getting your spells through. Contributes to will and deflection. You know, if this is anything like Dungeons and Dragons, the main skills are these. Increasing these, I would think, at least in Dungeons and Dragons, increasing something like this increases these things, or the defenses, the saving throws, which they call defenses, even more than just increasing the defense itself. So, with that in mind, I'm actually going to take this out. You know, I'll hold it on. Let's see what you guys think. I'll give it to him. He can get spells and stuff through. He can defend better against other spells hitting him. It'll be a good thing. Look, there's our floating skull. Ha 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 ha, we have Concelhaut's skull to follow us wherever we go. Now I guess he automatically just does these effects. These are automatic. One per rest. Grants visage of Concelhaut. Oh, I don't know if we maybe we can select the pet during combat. I don't know. 40 raw damage. I mean, it's not that much, but, you know, it's something else. And I don't think the pets can be injured at all, so... It's just like an extra ability. So before anything happens, before we set up some trap and then we all die horribly and we have to do this all over again, let me save. The only thing left after this is to fight that dragon, unless something's gonna, something else is gonna happen when we try to leave this place. This. These two are from the main. And that's it. These are the main game. Main game. Yeah, main game. I've discussed those before. Anyway, let's... Where you going, Skull? The book burns your hands when you touch it. Go over and get that ring. The clay tablet is ancient, and most of the symbols inscribed upon it are indecipherable. There's a hidden thing. Something over there.
Seen before.
Burns your hands. Yep, just keep burning our hands. We love it. It's an honor to have our hands burned by the books of Concelhaut. A pile of scrolls. We got a ring last time, didn't we? Scroll of Minoletta's concussive missiles. Oh well. Guess we rolled low on that one. Goes there. We're out of sneak.
Freshly greased.
I want to stay in sneak in case there's any more hidden stuff like that we can find. Nice. Two potions of major endurance, two potions of major recovery, two of major regeneration, and three rubies. I think a couple of us still need to be filled up with that. Or one of us. Stuff, guys. A scroll of confusion, two scrolls of hailstorm, and three scrolls of crackling bolts. I'm not sure if we have any of that stuff. They're all bluish. Here. Crackling bolt. Wait. Where did I see it? I lost it. Okay. These. What are these? Okay, we do have these. Okay, three skein bone. A sky dragon eye. Sky dragons are said to have almost supernatural vision, able to pick out the tiniest prey from far above the ground. Though clouded now with death, the iris of this massive eye retains its vibrant green-gold sheen. Well, I don't know what we do with that. What is this? Eothesian prayer, we have that. Missives of the Hand Occult, not sure about that. Primal Flame, Rock, Water, and Wind, and five lockpicks. So what's it called? Missives of the Hand Occult? Wait, I wanted that in here. It looks like that. Not completely sure if I've read it. I'll read it now. Dearest brother, or was it sister? May this letter find you in well spirits. A man of thuggish bearing stormed into my library the other day and demanded I help him find a book on the construction of an arquebus. I thought it proper service to wail to steer this man toward an illuminated manuscript on the subject of whittling toy soldiers and other miniature props. Unamused by my solution, I shrugged and said, "What is an answer without a question?" He did not find my spiritual rhetoric helpful or amusing, and so he punched out two of my teeth. I trust your summer has been less tumultuous than mine? In more important news, my apprentice claims she saw the eyeless face in a dream the other night. I admit I was so mad with envy that at first I refused to believe her. Well, forgive me for such a lapse of judgment. She described an Omawa of brilliant blue hues with a featureless face surrounded by a swarm of eyes. No two eyes alike. She claims Whale ignored her questions, and she can't recall any specifics of what was said. In fact, my apprentice seems to have forgotten many things since before the visitation. She could not tell me where she grew up or what she liked to eat. At first, I was so envious of her for having seen Whale with her own eyes, but it seems Whale's visit was to conceal, not to illuminate. I pray she endures this test of faith and can look back at the event and feel the joy of mystery. What is an answer without a question? Last week I felt the solution was ignorance, but after Whale's visit, I feel a road without length is closer to the capturing of the riddle. I worry my apprentice will look back at her visit from Whale and feel cheated, robbed of some moment of clarity we all thought we were owed when we first joined. I tried to tell her she was lucky, but she was too young to understand. What is an answer without a question? May I be dead, may my soul be scattered to the winds before anyone knows for certain. Yeah, that doesn't seem familiar to me. The rich fabric is as smooth as lambskin and softer than most beds. Well, he will cuddle in it no longer. Here's another podium here of books. I love these things. It's pretty cool. I'd love a podium like of books like this in my own house. Or a podium of books and video game boxes. We're both in one. Yeah, let's pepper search. Take arrows. A chain glitters from a middle shelf. You pull it and find an amulet in your hand. It's very tempting to, like, save scum and try different things. Oh, we got another spell word amulet. Which, we just found two of those things. It's the same. Yeah, it's plus 10. Same thing. Oh, stuff to sell. Oh, sneaky time.
Slowly now.
Keeps pulling us out of sneak. I don't like that. The rust-red figures on this scroll look as though they were written in blood. Okay, we got shelves here, too. The Moons of Eora. And two potions of barring death's door. It's a grayish book. I wish they went in, like, alphabetical order. Okay, this is another new one. The reason I know is because I would already have it in stash and it would say two. Look up in the night sky and you'll see the moon Palafa. Ubiquitous and persistent, she remains forever in view, but forever out of reach. What many people do not know, however, is that our world is actually orbited by two moons, Palafa and Kolda. Palafa, hanging low and large in the sky, Palafa travels swiftly in her race around the world, completing an orbit in about 18 days. This proximity and speed can cause extreme tide conditions in some areas, making the seas shift so quickly and rise so high that there are some beautiful coastal areas that are virtually uninhabitable for a good portion of the year. Amazing, huh? Before we learn the truth behind the cause of the tides, legend held that Andra, the goddess of the sea, was in love with the moon, and when she saw it in the sky, the tides, great waves, and violent storms that happened were her attempts to reach it. This is why the moon is formally called Sen Palafa or Andran Palafa, the beloved or Andra's beloved. Kolda. 315 years ago, the Grand Empire of Velia suffered from terrible storms and terrifyingly high and low tides. Records show the same thing was happening in the Adir Empire, and that several new Adirian colonies along the Deerwood Coast were completely destroyed by storms and high tides that engulfed the settlements. At that time, during an eclipse, Glanfathan and astronomers spotted something small orbiting near the edge of Balafa. After much study, they realized it was a small satellite with an extremely irregular orbit. They called it Calda Deb, or the Black Runner. Since it is smaller than Balafa, it doesn't have much effect on the world, but when it aligns with Balafa's orbit, it wreaks havoc on the tides and weather everywhere. This happens with an erratic frequency and severity and have been dubbed Lover's Tides. Calda has been rolled into the Andra myth, and when they are both in sight, her desire to reach them is increased tenfold, which is what causes the terrible weather. Interesting. Okay. I thought there was... There is another. Scroll of Missile Barrage. An obsidian lamp figurine. Summons three shades. Awesome. This lamp seems to swallow light, showing no reflection upon its surface. It's cold to the touch, and when held to one's ear, a quiet susurrus can be heard. The lamp is sealed with a piece of cork on which a single rune is inscribed. You know what? I wonder if this is where the whispering is coming from, because we can hear a quiet susurrus, or however you say it. The Life and Discoveries of Pangram, which I'm pretty sure we have. See if someone else has the scroll. Yep. Oh, that's the, what do you call it? The skull. This book contains a list of names, most of which are crossed off. You recognize the four names which haven't been touched yet. Sable, Peldon, Tanas, and Urariki. Those are the three, four princes. As you draw close, the words on this scroll fade and disappear. Is there a hidden panel on this side? Right, two new books. Awesome, though. Alright, let's see if anything bars our passage to get the hell out of here. There might be a few more of those orb things. Those hit hard, but we can kill them pretty easy. Pretty quickly, anyway. Nope, no more orb things. Now in that extra episode, well, last episode, we did explore this cave. From the inside going out. For any who didn't watch it because it was optional. Oh yeah, you go in this cave for a little while and then there's a wall. And well, that corner in the hallway leading up to Concelhaut's chamber, there's a switch. I pulled that switch and that wall came down, so then we were able to progress through the cave and we came out here and like, yep, that's it. That's the one. So we would have only been able to get so far if I had gone in from the outside. In fact, there'd probably be a quicker way out of here, but oh well. Slightly. Back to Cadnua. Azor has arrived. What is this? It's a shield. +12 deflection. Grants plus 12 shield deflection, bash, and winter wind. Area of effect spell. Ooh, it pushes and freezes. That's pretty cool. It's 12 deflection minus 4. I know we're running late, but... it's small. Nah, I'm not gonna buy it. Anyway. So I'm going to rest up. And, next episode, we'll try that dragon again. The dragon off of Longwatch Falls in that cave. The twin, the soul twin. Okay, just wanted to say that I was not able to defeat the dragon, so I'm not going to air that. Even with the help of Concelhaut, which I didn't realize, Concelhaut doesn't actually cause crush damage. Let me see if it says now. I think the pet doesn't say. Right. For some reason, this doesn't say anything. But, if you go in here... this is raw damage to yourself. The companion of Concelhaut's skull has the ability to call upon the Archmage's shade for assistance. While summoned, Concelhaut's visage will cast spells, but the summoner suffers raw damage for the duration as the undead wizard drains their life force. It was pretty cool. He's got the that crushing hammer spell. He's got some other kind of claw spell that drains life force and something else that I wasn't able to use because the dragon killed him right away. The dragon killed a bunch of us right away. And, he actually smashed my, our priest so hard that, the priest was completely out of health, not just endurance, so we could not raise him. And, once our priest was gone, everything went downhill from there. So, I'm gonna try the dragon again at the end of... oh, what do you call it? The White March Part 2. I will fight the dragon again. I will fight the foe at the bottom of the... well, the master below. At the bottom of the... what do you call it? The Endless Paths of Adnua. I'll fight him again. And, of course, we'll complete the game and fight Theos. So, we've got three foes lined up. And I'm sure they're going to have other tough bosses in White March Part 2. So, I might not be able to defeat those, but we should level up in Part 2 to the extent where we might be able to at least defeat the this dragon. So, yeah, sorry about that. It sucked. Even with the added might of Concelhaut and the extra character levels and the ability to resurrect people, they just died right away anyway. So, yeah, what can I say? Thanks for watching, guys. See you when they release Part 2, White March Part 2. I'm not sure to what extent I'll be playing it. I got stuff lined up, so it might wait a few weeks. I'm not sure. Or I might add another slot for, like, every other day or 3 days a week. Episodes will come out for a while. I don't know. So, because I have played a lot of Pillars of Eternity. A lot. Was it 214 episodes and then 57 episodes of this? So, yeah, we're going to be... yeah, that's a lot. This is a lot. Yeah, definitely. Hundreds of episodes. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, go strong.